is going on, everybody? Thank you so much for tuning in to CNET's very live coverage of the Sony PlayStation 5 games event. It's called The Future of Gaming. So thanks for tuning in. My name is Jeff Bacalar. We'll be with you for the next half hour, and then we're going to be talking over the event while it goes down. So stay with us. Joining me, Ashley Escada. What's going on, Ashley? How are you?
Hello, I'm good. I'm super hyped. Get on the train, everybody. Time for PS5.
And joining us as well, Mr. Eric Franklin. What's up, Eric?
Hey, Jeff. Thanks for having me. I'm on the train, too. I've been waiting on the train for months.
Yes, you bought your ticket early.
Train. Yeah. Ready for this train to start to get going. Yeah. I want to see some games.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be an interesting hour event is how long we're told it's going to go. I want to go around the room a little bit, and I want to ask you guys, you know, just as like this thing's getting started, it sounds like perhaps a couple of little tidbits have leaked out, if you will. We're still not 100% sure on everything, but what are you guys expecting to see? Ashley, what are you hearing?
I saw some of the leaks this morning. Who knows if they're true or not? I am hoping to see Parappa the Rapper 3. That's the goal. That's what I Parappa.
That's your long shot.
That's my long shot. And I think a sure bet or close to it would be Horizon Zero Dawn 2, because Guerrilla Games has been oddly quiet, and it's been just the right amount of time to hear from them about the sequel to such a great game. I'm so excited to see what Aloy's been up to. Those are the two things I am crossing my fingers to see today.
Yeah, it definitely feels like those guys are ready to, at the very least, announce. I don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we don't even know, are these games that they're going to be talking about today, are they going to be launch games? I don't think it's all going to be launch stuff, but sure. We can hope. Eric, what about you? What are you hearing?
I mean, I'm hearing the same things you guys are hearing. Everything, like from Horizon to Demon's Souls remake, Gran Turismo. I think, you know, I remember the time when you launch a new system, you definitely had a racer. So maybe Gran Turismo might fit that bill. Yeah. But also you had a fighting game, right? Like that was a way to show off the tech. So I'm kind of hoping for, like, if not a Tekken 8, then maybe like a new version of Tekken that takes advantage of the PS5, but is compatible with the previous generation versions.
Or, and hear me out, Dead or Alive Beach Volleyball sequel.
Oh,
let's go.
I like all these like real dark horse, like, you know, long prop bets. I'm coming
with the deep cuts today.
I feel like, you know, obviously the rumors that have been swirling around are kind of no-brainers. We talked about a sequel to Horizon Zero Dawn, a Spider-Man sequel maybe perhaps getting announced. There was also talk about maybe a new Ratchet and Clank game, which, you know, that's the same developer, so I don't know how you like
that'd be busy time.
Maybe something from the From guys. If it's a Bloodborne game, if it's a new sort of Demons-esque, you know, Dark Souls-esque sort of thing, I don't know. For me personally, like, I just want a little, you know, surprise. I want some new IP. I want some stuff that, you know, isn't really what everyone's expecting. And I think for me, at least, that's what always kind of gets me excited, is that sort of tease of something you've never seen before. But, But yeah, we'll see how it goes. I'm definitely curious to see how Sony positions this event, specifically how it's been comparing to what's come out and what Microsoft sort of platform has been, right? With Series X, you know, Sony is obviously very much like, hey, you're going to have to buy a new console, so this is what you're going to be doing. Whereas Xbox is more like, hey, you could play these games no matter where you are. So
yeah.
I don't know. What are you guys thinking in terms of that discussion?
I feel like, and Eric, like we're all probably on the same page here. Like, Sony has to come out today and talk about how they're going to compete with smart delivery on Xbox Series X. So, you know, PlayStation 4 is awesome, and there have been some major releases this year that are coming out. So we have Last of Us 2, we have Final Fantasy VII Remake Part 1. And Sony has to give a path to players to be able to have those upgrades. And I, like, maybe they tie it into PlayStation Plus. Maybe I'm not really sure how they're going to do that, but they absolutely need to have an answer to what Microsoft is doing with smart delivery. Like, that's a big one for me as a huge console gamer, as a person who loves my consoles. Like, that is a really big deal for me.
So yeah, smart.
Yeah, go ahead, Eric.
I was going to say smart delivery is huge, and it's one of the reasons I'm excited about the Series X. Mm-hmm. And, you know, officially PlayStation hasn't really talked about this yet. Although earlier this week, Bungie did announce that Destiny 2 would come to the PlayStation 5 and would have free upgrades to 4K resolution, 60 frames per second. So whether or not they brand it, they might talk about it. I'm not sure if they're going to brand it anything. They might say something like, you know, we recommend this to developers, but it's kind of up to them, which is kind of what Microsoft's saying, but it's. Yeah,
that'd be such a cop out, right? It's like you have to, they've got to really come out swinging and be like, we like are really kind of leaning on developers to do this program to, you know, if your games come out in the last, let's say 2 years, like we're really kind of hope, you know, this is the program where, you know, AAA developers are already on board. These are the games. Like I really feel like they have to come out and kind of, they got to come out swinging because Microsoft is selling some really compelling stuff with Series X.
Yeah, it's interesting. I think a lot of what it is just a basic sort of difference in philosophy, right? Because if you look at what, you know, so like I said before, you know, where Microsoft has this, you know, stance of like smart delivery, it doesn't necessarily, you know, go for what I think Sony is going for, right, guys? Like, I think, look, they've made it very clear. You're probably not playing any new PlayStation 5 game on a different console than the PlayStation 5. They've pretty much planted their feet in the sand saying, hey, we are a console by console sort of company. I think there's a different conversation to be had when you talk about backwards compatibility, because it does sound like that is a top priority of theirs. But I think where, you know, Microsoft says, hey, like you can play this game and no matter where you play it, you'll be playing the best possible version on that platform. You know, a lot of people forget they have so much bandwidth when it comes to PC, because if you're playing a game on Windows, Microsoft still wins, right? Because they own Windows. Yeah. They make Windows.
Sure.
So where, you know, I do find Sony and Microsoft much less in that sort of head-to-head competition, you know, as they maybe were, you know, 5-10 years ago.
I think you're right. And it would be interesting to see if maybe Sony has not really leveraged PlayStation Now in a way, kind of, you know, upscaling or whatever, what have you, for PlayStation 5. And, you know, if you have this, then you get that with, you know, your subscription or whatever. So it'd be interesting to see how they are going to respond to remote playing, which I think has been a trend that we've seen, you know, with not super successful outings like Stadia, but it is a really compelling thing. And if it can be done right, I think there would be a pretty significant argument to be made for something like what you were saying, Jeff, where it's like, no matter where you are, what you're playing, you're going to be playing the best possible version of it.
For sure. Yeah, Eric. Well, I mean, you know, you and Ashley just, you know, you put the case out there, smart delivery speaks to you. What do you think Sony could be sitting on or leveraging in that department when it comes to that sort of debate topic? What do you think they can sort of bring to the table?
Yeah, for sure. I think that, you know, one of the most compelling things about Microsoft right now is that being in the number two, maybe arguably number three position, you know, I feel like they have to give customers a lot of options. And they've been doing that, you know, especially with their messaging for Xbox Series X. And it's great. I think they're speaking directly to the consumer. I think Sony being in a number one position, I don't know if they have to do these things. I feel like Microsoft has had to do these things to get attention on them, really, to kind of stand out. And I think that one of the most compelling things about Game Pass for Microsoft, for me, is that all the first party games hit day and date.
Yeah.
You know, when that game comes out, you have it if you're a Game Pass subscriber. And I'm really wondering if Sony's going to go that route with their first party stuff. I doubt it. I feel like their stuff sells anyway, so why do that with PlayStation Now? But that would be really compelling to me.
Yeah, that's a really good point. I mean, there was a time where PlayStation Plus was the thing, right? Like that was sort of this untouchable, you know, behemoth. And now, obviously, that playing field is not even anymore. It's sort of just like Game Pass is just a better thing. Yeah. So, yeah, I definitely think they have to bolster that side of the argument. You know, it's funny. We're running some of that Mark Cerny keynote that was delivered a couple months ago. And it's just so wild to watch the different ways in which these two companies approach, you know, the dissemination of information. Like, I mean, this thing was just,
I love that mystery science theater layout, man.
Yeah, like, I mean,
the silhouettes of the people at the bottom. Yeah, so good. That's a nice touch.
Totally.
I kept wondering, are they moving or are they not moving? I can't tell.
It was super bizarre. Any way you slice it. I mean, you know, it's just two different sort of strategies, right? Two different sort of philosophies. And then with the controller coming out of nowhere, all of a sudden, you know, it does seem that Sony is definitely taking a more traditional sort of old school mentality.
Towards
how they're putting stuff out. And I think we're all in agreement in saying that this is really the first time that they are coming out and really laying out their cards when it comes to what you will be able to play on their platform. They keep calling this the future of gaming event, which, as you know, sort of irritating as that sentence is.
It's a game changer.
Yeah.
Let's get our buzzword cards out.
Totally. I think a lot about like the sort of leverage that Sony used to have, and I still think to this day has in terms of exclusive titles. But do you think that still matters in what this next generation is sort of shaping up to be?
I do.
Yeah.
I definitely do. When you have games like God of War, when you have games like Final Fantasy VII Remake, which is, you know, not, but anyway, when you have Horizon Zero Dawn, when you have Spider-Man, they have had a string of really good exclusives. And it just, you know, it's like when somebody comes to me and says, what console should I get? Always one of the biggest arguments is these are games you can only get on PlayStation. And there are a lot more of those, like really good games you can only get on PlayStation for, as opposed to, you know, there are some of those must-have games on Xbox, but they just are outnumbered by the number of exclusives, those really high profile exclusives on PlayStation.
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of a no contest. I mean, look, they're pumping out, you know, 50,000 Uncharted games, and look, I'm not gonna lie, I would play 50,000 Uncharted games.
Let's all be real here. Uncharted 50,000 is gonna be the best one.
But like, you know, it's funny because, you know, for a lot of people that I talk to, Halo doesn't necessarily have that kind of. You have that diehard sort of fan base, but for whatever reason, it doesn't feel like it is able to garner the same amount of momentum as something like a release from a Sony first party studio for whatever reason. Exclusives have been the story.
Yeah. I mean, I agree with you. Like Halo has, you know, has lost something since 2007, right? Mm-hmm. For whatever reason that is. I think, you know, you make a really interesting point in that Microsoft really has a lot to prove. They have to go a long way to get people excited about Halo again. They have a long way to get people excited about their first party games again. And that's the one thing we don't really know. We don't know for sure what they're working on first party wise. There's some rumors out there too. And, you know, they're going to have their event in July to show their first party stuff off. But I mean, I think that it's on them now, especially if Sony comes out strong, and I have no reason to doubt that they won't come out really strong today. They won't show everything because they're going to keep some stuff in their back pocket for sure, but they're going to come out swinging. And Microsoft has to answer, man. Like smart delivery, all that stuff is great. It comes down to the games. You know, yeah, are you going to make a compelling case?
But what good is that
case?
System, yeah, when you don't have the games?
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean, if you really want to walk back the timeline, it's like, man, Microsoft's been playing catch up for almost a decade now, right? Like they've had this, you know, sort of ability to be in that advantageous positional situation where they can, you know, build up this sort of attack where, you know, Sony's sort of like, okay, don't move. Everything seems to be going okay. Let's talk about maybe what we can expect, you know, out of this event, aside from perhaps the games, obviously games being the focus. Mm-hmm. Do you guys, I mean, let's talk price. Do you think that's a thing we're going to see? Do you think specific date is something we're going to see? I've seen a few rumors going around. And again, please just, you know, take this with a grain of salt. But there's just some stuff going around about there was a possible PlayStation 5 listing on a UK Amazon site that had it clocking in at like something absurd.
It's like £599.
Man, 600 pounds. That's a lot of money. That would be.
But then if you think about it in the way of, you know, what we see at like iPhone events and stuff, it would be $599 here. So it'd be the same. The number would be the same. It would just different currency, but still that is really expensive.
Yeah,
$600 in the middle of a recession is.
That's a tough pill to swallow.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a tough one.
And look, regardless if that's the price, and that again, I'm not totally sure that's something we're going to find out today, but if that is the price, it would line up with speculation. There's been plenty of reporting that says, you know, Sony has had a tough time keeping the manufacturing cost of this thing down.
Yeah.
That would kind of line up. You know, again, those $600 to me just seems so off the mark. I mean, I think anything above $450 for this thing, and they're already in trouble out of the game.
Yeah, I mean, I would say like tops $499, and like even then, that's really pushing it. Like maybe it'll be $499 for the first year, and then it'll go down to $449. But yeah, anything over $500, I mean, like you said, Eric, in the middle of a recession is like really, I don't know. That would be a really tough sell for a lot of people.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons. I was just going to say, it's one of the reasons I don't think they're going to announce price today. I doubt they're going to announce price. I think they're going to keep looking at it. Yeah. And I think, you know, Microsoft and Sony are kind of in this this game of chicken right now on price. Because as soon as one comes out, because we know what happened 7 years ago, Microsoft went to 500. Sony took all this stuff out of the box, camera and all that stuff, and went boom, 400.
$399, you know, and everybody went crazy. Oh my god!
Crazy. I was there. I was there with.
Yeah, I was too. And it was like Jeff there. I've never. That was intense. People were just losing their minds.
It was great. It was awesome.
It was a true like E3 moment.
Yeah, they're so good at that. I remember, man. I'm showing my age here.
The Final Fantasy VII remake announcement. I started crying. Like I remember, I was sitting next to Ian Scher, and I started crying. Like it was too much.
You weren't the only one either. Yeah. But I remember 24 years ago when after Sega had announced the Saturn was out and was $400, and then Sony at their E3 press conference, I forgot who it was, but some exec just went up to the we're gonna announce the price. Went up to the podium, said $299. And just walked off the stage.
Yeah, that was amazing. So great. Oh, the times of E3 passed. We would be at E3 this week were it not for a global pandemic, which is really unfortunate.
Yeah, it's pretty wild. I will say this, though. I think, you know, having this sort of setup, you know, obviously when you talk about like the cost of things, like going to E3 is not a cheap endeavor. Mm-hmm. I think there is something kind of amazing about this new sort of setup. You know, this situation has accelerated, you know, progress in a lot of ways. And I feel like an efficiency. And I just feel like this could be a thing where, you know, depending on how, I guess, this sort of cycle goes, will dictate whether or not, you know, E3 ever comes back, or at least comes back in a way that we remember it. And I mean, judging by the way things are going, I feel like that's probably just not going to happen.
I think I was just talking about this with someone last night, what the future of E3 is. And I genuinely think that it's very possible, if not likely, that we'll see sort of a shift towards something similar to CES, where the first day is a press day, but everything will kind of be remote. So you'll have your state of play, you'll have your Nintendo Direct, you'll have all that stuff. And then and all of the publishers will do their really cool little, you know, things. And then and everyone will report on it. And then E3 itself will just be an open to the public ticketable experience. So there's no Because the really hard thing about E3 in past years, when they've opened it up a little bit to the public, is that it was not really intended. Like, it doesn't really work when you're trying to show a bunch of journalist stuff behind closed doors that you weren't quite ready to announce yet, or that you, you know, that you weren't quite ready to get into. So it does seem like there's an opportunity there maybe for an open to the public type of event that's very similar to, say, a PAX. But yeah, I'm not really sure where they go from here. I know E3 has kind of been on the decline for a little while. I mean, Sony pulled out of the show. Microsoft started going to the Microsoft Theater. Like, they weren't in the convention center. EA started having its own event offsite. So it's been kind of decomposing, I guess. Like, it sounds really terrible, but yeah, it's been kind of falling apart for a while now. So it will be very interesting. Like you said, Jeff, it's been accelerated because of the pandemic, but who knows what the future of E3 holds.
Yeah, it's definitely wild. What do you guys think Sony can do? Because obviously, you know, the big thing with a console launch is being able to move, you know, product right away. And I've really sort of been scratching my head as to how that argument can really get made, A, with the sort of economical situation that's happening on the planet, and B, you know, the sort of software pitch where, you know, you have these games that have been delayed because of the pandemic, and you have, quite frankly, possibly, you know, one of the best sort of games to ever end a console cycle. What do you guys think they can do between now and launch to really make that case? Because to me, it's felt like a sort of wait and see situation since the start of the year.
Well, I mean, I think that starts today, right? I think they need to come out and show something really, really impressive. Now, that doesn't mean that, you know, if they show Horizon Zero Dawn 2, that game, I fully expect that game to be graphically the best looking game ever, because mm-hmm. Guerrilla Games is amazing at this kind of stuff. And, you know, the PlayStation 5 is a beast, you know, based on the specs. I think that, you know, having something that's an order of magnitude better than what we've seen in The Last of Us 2, even running on a PlayStation 4 Pro, I think they have to really, and it's going to be difficult on a, you know, on a stream to do that, but, you know, you can go back and watch these videos, but they really have to push, I feel like they really have to push the graphical limits of these games to really make it a compelling case to shell out, you know, whatever, however much it's going to cost, right after they've had this high watermark of this, you know, The Last of Us 2 coming out.
For me, I think it's that all of the games that we've been talking about have been either like sequels or remasters. And I need to see a game I can't get anywhere else but on PS5 mm-hmm. that not only knocks my socks off, but puts my socks on before it knocks them off, because I don't wear socks anymore because I don't leave the house. Like, that's that's where I'm at.
Yeah, I think, you know, and that's the thing. Like, I saw that rumored sort of list, and it's just like sequel, sequel, sequel. And
remake, sequel, sequel. Yeah.
And, you know, look, like, you have The Last of Us 2 coming out. Yeah, but there was like almost a decade in between those two games.
Right.
You know, I think the search for new IP and compelling IP, like, to get a new franchise off the ground is no easy task. And you have publishers who are trying to be as risk averse as possible with investing in something that's fresh and mm-hmm. something that, you know, no one's ever really done before. It makes me think, like, you know, the, not to say that the era of the AAA, you know, sort of blockbuster, you know, exclusive is going away, but I feel like it leaves room open for there to be exclusivity in terms of more independent stuff. And I know, you know, in the last generation, that was, for me, I mean, you talk about what you're going to recommend in terms of consoles. For me, the fact that you could really play pretty much every indie game, save for the ones that were sort of gobbled up on PS4 and or PC, that kind of sealed the deal for me. Hopefully that will have some of the spotlight today, for sure.
Well, so in the time we, like, in the last year, Greg Rice, who used to be at Double Fine, makers of fine games such as Psychonauts, is now at Sony, and he is the new global head of indie gaming. And I think that that is a really big deal. And I think that I sincerely hope Microsoft does not underestimate the power of Greg Rice in that role. Like it is a very big deal. And Sony has already done such an excellent job with indie studios and really fostering those studios, making sure that they have the resources they need and, you know, getting the word out on those games. And so I really feel confident about the indie. Like, I love indie games. It is my favorite thing to go see at E3 every year. The IndieCade mega booth is 10 out of 10. You always find cool stuff there. And I really do think that they have a very strong secret weapon, not so secret weapon, I guess, in Greg Rice.
Yeah, and you can count these in indie games as kind of almost, especially the exclusive ones, they're almost like first party AA games, right?
Yeah.
That really kind of, and if they can take advantage of the SSD, the PlayStation 5 architecture, and to your point, Ashley, show you something that can't be done on any other system, I think that's going to, you know, play through their strengths.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's wild. I'm just scrolling through my Twitter sort of feed here, looking at what people are talking about. A lot of people still mentioning showing more of the controller. Again, yeah. This is probably going to be primarily a game focused event, but what did you guys think of that controller? The, what are they calling it? The DualSense.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What do you guys think of that? For the first time in many years, a departure from that form factor, for sure.
Yeah, I was going to say, finally, the only thing I thought of when the first time I saw it was, finally, my hands will feel much better when I play like 4 hours of Overwatch and comp. Like, this is basically like the shape of this thing is so much better than the DualShock. Much more Xbox-esque, one might argue, or the Pro Controller for the Switch. I am very excited about this. I'm very curious to see if they offer or they will end up kind of doing something similar to what Xbox does with the Elite controller and make something or an add-on to it that kind of enables the ability to kind of make it a little bit more customizable and or give you better controls in the back. I am very excited about that lovely, rounded, fuller shape that will not give me little claw hands when I'm done playing.
I've never met someone who did not like the DualShock 4. You don't like the DualShock 4?
I hate it.
Really?
There are two shooters that I play. I play Overwatch on console. I play Splatoon on the Switch. So I use the Pro Controller for the Switch. And then if I move over to the DualShock controller, like, I am one of those people who just like, I grip that controller like my life depends on it. And it does in game. And, you know, people need their heals in Overwatch. And so for me, it is very much a thing of over time that the thinness of the handles of the controller end up cramping my hands really bad. So also I have giant Lana Kane hands, just like an archer. Fair. So that's my problem.
That is fair. Just a heads up. The event should be starting any minute. When it does start, we'll sort of let that take the main stage here. We will be talking over it, so stay with us for sort of on-the-fly live commentary. We appreciate you sticking around with us. Eric, are you a fan of the DualShock 4, or do you hold Ashley's opinions in the same regard?
I'm much more of an Xbox controller fan. Xbox One. You know, it took me a while to get used to the Xbox One. Yeah, the 360 was probably the best controller ever made, but the Xbox One is slowly taking that that title away. I'm wondering, you know, the DualSense is supposed to be pretty expensive, right?
I don't know exactly, you know, the cost. They haven't said that yet, but there's been speculation.
$80, $100.
I'm wondering why, right? Like, is there something about that controller they haven't revealed
yet? DualSense is expensive, man. It's two senses.
Two senses, not just that's one. True. I know. You know. Dual shocks, two shocks.
Yeah,
$60 worth. Yeah. But two senses, that's like.
Yeah.
It's not going to be cheap. Yeah, I don't know.
It looks cool.
It does. I think it is aesthetically, it's pretty dope. Yeah. I like how they move the light from the top of the sort of controller to flanking the sides. I think that was sort of a nice, slick move. But yeah, for me, that's, it sounds like you probably will be able to use DualShock 4s, right? I think that's something they did say. I don't remember 100%, but it sounds like you might be
able to
use those on the PS5. But yeah.
Do you think we'll see a silhouette of the console? Like, you know, similar to how they sort of tease, like they tease this controller. They have sort of a little silhouette of it. Do you think we might get a glimpse? I know they probably won't say like, this is the PS5. I mean, that would be amazing. Nobody would complain about that if they did it. Sony, are you listening?
Maybe, but like, I also don't care what these things look like. Everyone freaks out about like, this thing could look like a lobster and I'd be like, fine, I don't care. I'm playing
video. If it looked like a lobster, that would be so awesome.
Right? Like, I don't know where I've
Give me the craziest shape you can do. Oh, here we go.
All right.
It's happening.
Starting with the trailer. Let's do it.
It's mature content. I don't belong here. Could this be?
It's in that box.
Control? No, this is just the intro. This reminds me of Control.
I'm gonna figure this out.
It's the PlayStation triangle.
That's how the triangle gets made.
It's 3D printed. It's beautifully it's laser etched from one single white cube.
Confirm. PS5 is a 3D printer.
I wonder if the console's white because of all of the. There's been a lot of white and blue. The controller, it's very interesting.
How many people are yelling at their screens talking about they're wasting time? Get to the games.
I would be doing it right now if I did not have to contain myself.
Oh, these poor FX make graphics design people who spend hours doing this.
You know what? High fives to you graphics people at Sony. You did a great job.
It's just the four shapes we got.
It's classic.
Ooh.
There we go, okay.
You ever wonder, like, different choices, how we might have ended up?
No. I like the hand we've been dealt.
Nice. The nerve to put Knack in there.
The nerve.
That was sick.
They gotta start off by, totally. They gotta start off by hitting us in our nostalgia feels.
Yep.
Like, remember all this good stuff we did?
It's also kind of aligns our expectations. We expect a lot better than, together, graphically than this.
We were destined for something great.
This is amazing.
Wonder how they're gonna do these things.
Why did I move here?
Oh wow.
I guess it was the weather.
Or coming out strong.
I don't know. That thing.
Oh, that's magic. Michael from GTA 5.
I thought we was trying to get out of this bullshit.
You sounding more and more like a snee-eye itch every day.
My job! My score!
Get out!
Maybe they're gonna show PS5 upgrade.
Sure.
We should talk sense.
Comparison action.
We are gang banging like it's 91.
They just show PS5 and it's like Goodfellas.
Yeah, it's just
We all love banks.
Well, and also I think they need to be really clear about which is 4 and 5.
Yeah.
So this is a.
Give me a hand with these bodies.
This cannot be traced back to me.
Champagne, anyone?
Just sort of smash things.
I mean, I am surprised this is what they're leading off.
Now what?
Yeah, this is...
Unless they're just going to say, like, hey, 6.
There you go. Yeah, exactly. Oh, and 6.
Expanded
okay,
enhanced. All right. Okay.
Expanded and enhanced.
Okay. I don't think that showed off the enhancements.
That's a lead. That's a lead off, I guess.
That's one way to do it.
Okay, there you go.
Oh, here's the bolstering of PS Plus.
$1 million. That's a nice incentive, that I guess. Is
awesome, like oddly specific, like
it's very specific.
Until this game launches,
you're gonna get a $1 million virtual payout.
This is like the New Line Cinema logo.
Yes,
this is it. Like this glass acrylic.
Reminds me of Lord of the
Rings. Wouldn't it be wild if that was like
it
on
was
the
great
actual console?
To kick today off with a look back at just some of the seminal moments of the last 25 years. And what better way to bridge our past and our future than with a game that's graced every PlayStation console, Grand Theft Auto. It's been a privilege partnering with Rockstar Games for many years now, and we're thrilled to open today with the news that that partnership will continue with PlayStation 5. It's now just over a year since we began sharing technical details of PlayStation 5, but today's the day that we've been looking forward to for years, when we get to show you just some of the games that demonstrate our belief that PlayStation 5 marks the biggest generational transition our industry has yet seen. The content okay. we've curated
those are,
for
those
this
are
event
bold words.
Showcases how PS5 has inspired developers to create new experiences that are transformative in how they look, sound, and feel. Enough from me. We're going to have the games do our talking.
Right.
Okay.
Recorded
that. Oh, all right. Here we go. I think this is going to be good. PlayStation Studios. Spider-Man!
Spider-Man! That's
Spider-Man!
Dad, that has to be a shocker.
Oh.
He was right.
What up? Miles.
Now it's your turn. Go be a hero, Miles. Yep.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Okay. Let's do this.
Very cool.
That looks really good. Wow. I'm into that title.
Oh, wow. Huh.
Yeah. Is that a, wow, is that a full game?
Well, that's the thing. It kind of, I don't know.
今日は皆さんに僕らが作っている新しいグランツーリスモの情報をシェアできるということで、すごく興奮しています。今回のグランツーリスモはおそらくこれまでのねグランツーリスモの、ファンの方が、プレイしたらあの本当に嬉しいんじゃないかなっていう、キャンペーンモードを中心にしたグランツーリスモになってると思います、
yeah.
ぜひ楽しみにしていてください。
This is a welcome surprise.
Grand
here's,
Turismo, yeah.
Here's your racer, Franklin.
Yeah, I know. Oh, look at that. I mean, already. Look at that.
Switches. I'm sold.
Exactly, man. They've never rendered switches before.
You've never seen switches like this.
It's clean.
And I promised you this game's been in development for 43 years, so...
Still bad.
Yeah, it's a little loud, but it's not.
Yeah, it's good. Really good. Four of us.
Better?
Yeah, that's good. That's really good.
Okay.
Look at that sky. Sorry, I get impressed by these things, man.
Look at those trees!
I know. Well, that's... I mean, the cars are already excellent, right? So, where do you go?
Seven. GT7.
Tim Stevens
is
very
wow.
excited.
Yeah, seriously, right?
What?
Is this PlayStation Home? What is this?
Okay.
Wow, okay. Man.
Wow. can hear Tim's screaming.
This is actually, they just used Tim Stevens as the model for those hands driving.
Totally. I mean, you know, if this is, I mean, if I feel like Gran Turismo in its original sort of heyday had, I mean, it still does, I'm sure, a fan base kind of that was just super obsessed. This has to be a really awesome 3D.
And is it? It's like a tradition to have a new GT game. So yeah, almost. Yeah, it's not not every. Is it every console? Not every. PS4 did. I don't think have.
Yeah, maybe you're right. PS2, PS3. Definitely PS2.
Yeah.
This looks great.
Looks, all right, looks like a good driving sim.
Certainly the real driving simulator. Let's see what else we got.
What's next? PlayStation Studios. Here we go.
All right, something cartoony. Check this out.
Oh, there.
It's Jak and Daxter.
I was thinking, are they making a comeback? That's the other one.
You all right back there?
No, it is.
No,
go.
That's Ratchet.
Oh no, that's right.
It's Ratchet. It appears that the dimensions are collapsing on one goodness. Another.
So maybe they made two little games.
Get to
right.
The ship. I mean, we can't be that far.
I have it in my sight.
They have found.
I mean,
us,
that
Ratchet.
PlayStation Studios money is going a long way. Insomniac.
I'm gonna steer this thing. I really ask nicely. Watch this.
Slow down, please.
I will rewatch this in 4K tonight.
Yeah, that's my opinion.
The dimensions are weakening considerably.
Can I say, wow, that looks so good. So
kind of showing
off. I really loved the PS4 Ratchet Clank. It's very good.
Well, it is certainly not good.
And again, you know, yeah, this looks great, right?
Yeah.
I always
the way they're going through all these different environments.
Yeah, I always look for a caveat to that. Is this
didn't he say that at the beginning?
Yeah, they said everything was captured with the PS5 in game.
Great. That, I mean, the level of detail, even not at 1080p, that looks great.
Yeah.
Particle effects, lighting, all that stuff.
The reflections on Clank are very nice.
The way they were going through all those different environments so quickly, Ratchet. That was definitely showing off the essence.
We are too late. Ratchet?
Who?
Oh, cool.
It's a lady, it's a lady Ratchet.
All right. I'm into it.
Hi, I'm Marcus Smith, creative director at Insomniac Games. The entire studio is so excited to be able to share with you a first-ever look at Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, a brand new, full-length, interdimensional adventure built from the ground up for the PlayStation 5. We're doing things we've never been able to do before, like use dimensional rifts to be able to leap from planet to planet nearly instantly, or put ray trace reflections on Clank. All of our alien worlds are filled with density and life previously unseen. Plus, Ratchet's all-new arsenal is more exciting than ever thanks to the DualSense controller's enhanced feedback. Ratchet and Clank are near and dear to our hearts at Insomniac, and we can't wait to share more with you in the future. But for now, here's another look.
All right.
Did you see
that? That's so cool.
So funny, there came a time where I was like, I just want to see if I can play this with my kid because he'd love this. And now, what I'm looking at.
Okay. It's Ratchet and Clank!
Sand shots from above.
I just want to know if Mr. Zircon is also in this game.
Sand my heroes!
Was that a kraken? Or at least a very large octopus? I will never get used to that.
Just pretty.
Hey, break reality.
Don't let him get to the boss!
It is some great stuff with the last one, so I'm really looking forward to this.
I'm just take over the universe again.
Yeah.
Jump into a different.
I kind of wish he was doing a worse job.
Like, look, it's actual literal.
That's what I'm afraid of.
In the particle effect.
I mean, I love a good cartoon. That effect is.
Yeah, it's pretty rad.
Pretty rad.
That's them designing around. The
yeah,
hardware,
what we can do, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, super fast SSD. How can we capitalize on that? You know, let's give Ratchet a portal gun, basically.
Yep.
That's all of them.
That's their first brand new Ratchet in a really long time, right? I mean, the one that was on PS4 was mostly a reboot of the original, right?
Is that true?
Yeah. All right, more shapes, more 3D printed fun.
I feel like that kind of clear acrylic is like maybe on the actual machine. They're gonna like zoom out on it someday. Oh, okay, Square Enix.
It's very Christopher Nolan dropping those hints throughout the
presentation.
Yeah. Not her. Okay. This seems new.
Yeah.
I don't recognize.
Looks great.
Is this?
Oh.
Okay.
Super into like whatever this is.
Wow, that looks great.
Yes, I like it. Project. Athia?
I don't know.
Athia? We'll see. Giving me a very Shadow of the Colossus vibe.
Yeah. I wonder if this is
exclusively for PlayStation 5. See, this is the type of stuff I was talking about. Like, show me something and put my socks on, knock them off, and then make me buy the console.
But why did it say designed exclusively?
Because it was built for the PS5 from the ground up.
Right,
like,
but why?
No.
Why? Yeah.
They didn't start development on PS4 and then shift to PS5.
Okay.
This is.
That's what I assume that means.
Bloopers game? No. No.
It's an Annapurna Jam. Okay. It's a robot in the trash.
Oh no, trash robot?
RIP human. This is the end of the pandemic, guys. The only thing left. Cats and robots.
This is 1 year from now.
This is the scrapped version of WALL-E.
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. I dig the color vibes here.
I just hope this isn't a world where, like, cats are the best, because I would be upset if that's what's happening.
Hey, come on.
Deeply upsetting.
Just like, no, we cannot have a...
Oh, no, Jeff, you might be right. Look.
No, not a cat game like this.
Some
no.
Some kind of backpack.
No, they're not
going to be into it.
Are they?
I got my two cats right here. They're loving this.
Is the audio gone? I can't hear these robots speaking.
Yeah, it keeps coming back in and out.
If I play as a cat, I'm going to be upset.
I think that's what it is. Oh my God, you are going to play it. This is what?
Yep. They're going to force you to play this game.
Straight.
You're playing as a cat, let me tell you. You are playing as a cat.
Into it. Love an Annapurna Jam, and I know that's going to be cool.
I get it. A dog wouldn't be as nimble.
So this is definitely launch... window
yeah.
kind of thing. Kind of
I mean,
stuff.
Yeah. Nothing has actually said launch yet.
Except for Spider-Man said 2020.
It said holiday.
That's right.
That could not be, you know, launch. Christmas Day.
I think when they did that for PS4, it ended up being like holiday ended up being like a week before Christmas or something like that. Oh, here's that SSD. Render, render, render.
That thing kicking up the dust. Hell yeah, USB-C. It's about damn time.
Ugh, thank you.
It's a little long on the headset jack, but on this
third dimensional audio.
All right. Those are just some of the features of the PlayStation.
Those beautiful shapes.
It is
making games used effect. To be about these constant trade-offs between the artistic vision and technical limitations. With PS5, we're not going to be burdened like that. We're going to be able to realize our artistic vision a lot better. It's got a ton of horsepower, which is very easy to unlock, and it's a machine that's really easy to develop on. The PS5 will present a paradigm shift as to what players will come to expect from gaming will let us tell stories, make worlds, create gameplay that I think will truly captivate the player and really surprise quite a few people. Please take a look at this new franchise for Worldwide Studios coming exclusively for PlayStation 5.
He left Guerrilla, right, to work for PlayStation?
I believe so. All okay, stars. This is what they've been working on.
Oh,
my PS4 was a
what's it called?
Rezo Gun machine. This is the they stopped making those arcade shooters to make this.
What was their last game?
Forget the name of it.
Was it Rezo Gun?
Rezo Gun was the one that was the launch title they put out on PS4. Attack. Yeah. They had death. I believe they had one or two games between.
Oh, Matterfall. Wait,
Matterfall. That's the one.
Trapped in this endless cycle.
They're just like, space. It always has to be space.
yeah. We need it to be in space. It has to be weird, and it needs to be in space. That's a Housemarque classic. Housemarque hallmark.
Each time I awake, this planet seems somehow.
Is it just a coincidence that her voice sounds like Sigourney Weaver?
It is Sigourney Weaver.
That seems like it is.
Uh-oh.
My mind. Oh, no. Well, it's a gladiator shot.
Yep.
You know, I wonder if the new trick is going to be this, like, SSD instant population.
Instant travel.
Yeah. Hope.
It seems like that's the easy go-to, right?
Yep.
It's like a fun party trick.
Stunning.
It's effective.
Choice is to keep
yeah, and then a couple of years you'll see them kind of expand.
To keep looking for answers.
Why has this helmet, this space helmet, like transcended film, TV, and now games? Like, it's the same one every time.
That's it. Just works. Messing it around.
I guess so.
She had two different color eyes.
So many shapes, you guys. Just so many shapes.
Just approaching the half hour mark.
There's a whole four.
What?
Here's your Garfield game.
Finally.
Oh no.
You might not be off.
Oh god. Wait, what?
This is unsettling.
Oh, it's Sackboy.
Yeah, okay.
Well, yeah, these guys, I think, handled some part of Little Big Planet.
Ooh, this looks so cute.
I like the song.
I'm a Vita version.
I'm a real sucker for cute stuff, and this looks so cute. I love a cute look. I'm here for all cute platformers. Just put them in my veins.
Hey, someone.
Load times, Eric. Load times.
I know. They're amazing. That's a kind of a Trolls World Tour vibe.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Okay.
What's next? Again. Another PlayStation Studios jam. Lucid. Oh. What's this business?
This is the SSX of
Thunderground. Some kind of battle royale. Oh, with cars.
Fortnite with cars, yep.
Can I say, I have been yelling about wanting Twisted Metal Battle Royale for the longest time, and I'm so sad that this isn't that.
I mean, that'd be great.
It's like, it's just like, seems like the most perfect Battle Royale with cars. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know why the rules are like everything Battle Royale has to be like.
Shooty man's.
Shot out of dead mouse's like butt. This is what we're getting.
I'm never gonna forget that you said that. I'm gonna think about it every time I see a new battle royale. It's for the kids, like, Jeff. It's for the kids.
I'm gonna try to forget that he said.
Jeff Bacalar, cantankerous old man.
No, I
you're
mean,
gonna
like...
get quoted on some gaming website that's like Jeff Bacalar, millennial.
It's not a bad quote.
Yeah, says all battle royales look like they came out of.
Jeff, what's that game your son loves? Rocket League, yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's like very
Destruction
League.
Derby, Rocket League, and Fortnite.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I'm into it.
It looks cool. I'll try it. Why not?
All right.
Looks fun.
Do you know we still got heavy hitters?
Yeah, there's still a lot.
Hello, everyone.
That we
my
haven't
name is
heard
Josh
from
Greer,
yet.
And this is my brother Mike. We're from Ember Lab, a small team with a background in film and animation.
And we're very excited today to share with you the first look at our new game. It's a story full of adventure and charm that has themes in personal growth and redemption. So please enjoy.
Hi.
Those guys probably work out. I'm just jealous. That's the only reason I said that.
You look great, Eric.
Yeah, you look great.
Thank you.
Oh, this is too cute for me.
Oh boy, this might be it. This might be too cute. Ooh.
This is all right.
I know you are kind.
Give me all the cute stuff.
You sense the power that flows through this.
Oh, I'm getting a real cameo type vibe from this, even though I know that's like it's Microsoft Jam now.
Oh, that looks nice though.
Ooh.
Driven by the belief that you can help these troubled spirits.
I like this thing. This I need to see in 4K.
But
yeah.
You cannot hide your weakness from me.
I mean, this might as well be a movie.
Well, they said they're, you know, they do film stuff too. So this is cool. This is like very cinematic. I like, I'm really digging
this.
Well,
this part definitely is a movie.
You think so? I'm kind of taking them at their word that everything is real there, or at least in engine.
That looks like it.
No. Okay, that's a game.
Wow.
Oh,
the sound went away. I didn't bring it back.
Okay.
All right.
I'm very much into whatever these things are called. I would like one.
I want one. House. Give me it. Yeah, they have, like, it looks like some of them have personalities. Like, oh, look, that one has hair. Those are grass hair. Little action adventure.
Yep. I feel like I know exactly what I'm getting here and I want
it. Yeah. Into the new IP.
Yeah.
It has a, what's that Ubisoft game that everyone wants a sequel to? That they announced a sequel to, but they never. Good and Evil.
Beyond Good and Evil?
Yeah.
Kenna. Spirits.
All right. I'm into it, Ember Lab. Bring it.
I want to know more. Tell me more. I don't know if you guys know this, but those shapes, They mean PlayStation.
I didn't know that. Thanks for clearing that.
We hadn't seen them before, so I just wanted to.
Oh yeah.
Wanted to clarify.
You ever feel like you're just waiting for a sign?
All the time.
To do that thing you've always meant to do.
Whoa.
Okay.
Sometimes I feel like I'm standing on the edge of doing great things.
Yeah.
This looks like a Tumblr come to life.
Something's Maybe it's
it's good.
Maybe it's the fear that I'll never be as good as what I imagine when I'm still just standing on the edge. But if we've got nothing else to lose, might as well jump.
This is for all the class of 2020 graduates. I love a weird indie, so
let's do it.
I'll be keeping an eye on that one.
What are these guys?
And who could say?
I have no idea.
Hi, I'm Lorne Lanning, and I'm here to share with you a game that I've been dying to make.
I wasn't expecting.
It's an emotionally engaging story where rescuing is rewarding, failure is devastatingly hilarious, and the memories should last you a lifetime. Take a look.
Failure is hilarious. Also, what I'm putting on my tombstone. Man, I love Oddworld.
No longer a slave, Abe.
When was the last Oddworld game?
It's been a minute. It's been a minute. Led them here.
You may have escaped the murderous blades, but the fate of your entire people is up to you.
It's always up to him.
Yeah, he's got no choice.
Why is it always on Abe?
That's it.
He needs
this
a break.
This is his curse.
This is very, I mean, it's a very odd world, but also like that looks very good.
I wonder if it's like an expansion of like.
It looks like, oh.
This looks like a new Oddworld game, like an entirely new thing.
But you still have your minions.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Come on. This is a next generation Oddworld.
Yeah. I will play this.
I don't know if I like that face, but that's upsetting me.
Fair. I think you can reasonably say that. Soulstorm.
Okay, Soulstorm.
I did not see any hilarious failure there, but I'll look harder. I'll look again.
PlayStation 5 によって我々の考える東京のビジュアルを実現できました.
This is Ghostwire.
Oh,
wow. This is Nakamura was on this game and then she left.
This is the first gameplay video.
He said, came out and she was like, it's spooky, and it was so cute. And the whole internet fell in love with her.
Which publisher was that?
This is Tango.
That's the developer. I wonder.
Oh, who's publishing?
Yeah.
Hello, Tokyo. Someday I'm going to get there.
You see things others can't.
Okay.
Oh, Bethesda did like the Evil Within's, right? So that's probably who's gonna put this out.
Okay. All right.
Oh, I love me a ghost fight in a Japanese schoolgirl outfit.
Not for my kids, for sure.
Yes, this one will be played after bedtime.
E for everyone.
It's up to you.
Everyone who likes Tokyo. Scary stuff. This is giving me a very Dishonored vibe.
It was interesting because it left such an impression with that cinematic trailer. Mm-hmm. Okay. So I guess the foregone conclusion is that this will not be a PS4.
Yeah, I guess not.
Definitely getting like Suda vibes too.
That's a good pull.
Okay.
Okay, like that's some cool nightmares. That's some cool nightmares.
I gotta say, I'm not into the whole Dying Light first person without a gun kind of gameplay. That always weirds me out.
Okay, well, I was gonna mention Control, but the thing is, you do have guns in that game. They're just different. Also, Eric, have you played Control? If you have not, you should.
I have not. Oh, it's on my list.
You gotta play that one.
It's a long list.
Oh, it's so good. Put it, bump it, bump it up a little. Bump it up to the top. Okay. This looks weird.
Yeah. Oh, nice.
Okay.
Huh.
Okay. Something new, something different. Carve out a future for a people. Oh no, they're haunted by oblivion. I don't know what this is, but this is curious.
Yeah, I mean, they definitely have a vision, that's for sure.
Yeah, they have a very clear point of view on this.
I never played that Sword and Sorcery game.
I played it when it first came out on my iPhone 4, probably, or something.
Yeah.
That was a while ago.
It's clearly not that, but...
Yeah, I don't know what's happening. But I mean, that's kind of a...
They're like, we played No Man's Sky.
Yeah, now we have some notes.
Yeah.
Get to the far shore, okay?
All right. I'm sort of glad it's not just giant heavy hitters.
2020, okay.
Yeah, I mean, some stuff. You know, that's what we were talking about, right? Like, we...
Well, if we remember on PlayStation 4, like, there was no super huge launch title. Like, at launch, my PlayStation 4 was a Resogun machine.
Yeah.
Because I got it for free.
Mac.
Yeah, yeah. Gearbox. Yes. Yeah, I was just like, is this Godfall? Because this is not the way it was presented to us previously.
That's very different from what, remember that first trailer from the Game Awards?
It was extremely serious. Yeah, there was a very somber tone.
Yep.
It was a very strange shift.
Yes, it was kind of depressing, actually.
Guys,
we're going to pivot. We're going to do a hard pivot.
Oh, okay. Heart Machine. I like this.
Oh, okay.
I was a huge fan of Hyper Light Drifter.
I haven't played it.
Oh, that list you got.
I know. I bought it for like a dollar on Steam a couple years ago.
Look on Franklin's game list.
We're gonna hit the bells and shame black you hole. As you walk away.
Please do. I need the motivation.
Game,
oh,
game,
you can
shame.
Surf a black hole in this game.
Who doesn't want to surf a black hole? That's all I'm saying.
Cool.
Is man, I love weird games. Ooh. Is this what's inside my body? Oh, the void's calling. How do they get this number?
Wait a minute, you can instantly portal to other locations, huh?
Instantaneous. I like that this character's head is like a burnt out match. It's very
pretty. Darksiders 2 a bit.
Whoa.
That's the video game name right there.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna play the hell out of that game.
I mean, that was on Genesis, I think it was, right?
No, I'm Scratch.
Sounds like it was, though.
You're right? Not wrong. You're not wrong. That's very true.
Well, we're getting our game's worth, guys.
Get us some games.
There are defo some games. We've only got about 15 minutes left.
Yeah. I'm at the point that I'm annoyed by the shapes now.
Yeah, you're upset with them?
Yeah.
We need to call.
Oh, Hitman.
Is this a Hitman situation we have here?
Yeah. The barcode is back.
Gonna end like this.
The giant bomb guy's gonna be very excited.
All your hard work, all your sacrifice, only sped up the process.
Or is this just another bald guy?
He's the Blair Witch. He lives in the woods. Flashlights. So many bright lights in your eyes.
And now,
this can't be Alan Wake, right?
You find yourself alone.
Is Microsoft got the rights to that?
Oh, was that you still remedy? Get like an origami. Mm-hmm.
Only death awaits.
Oh, is this what I think it is?
I think it's a hit. I mean, it's Hitman, right?
Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's a Hitman. Death awaits. Look, joke's on you, Hitman. We're in the middle of a pandemic. It's already here.
Yeah, but like, okay, so Hitman 3 is not...
Ion Interactive.
Well, let's listen.
In Hitman 3, Agent 47 is back for his most intimate and professional contract in his entire career. This is also the dramatic conclusion for the World Assassination trilogy. I'm so proud to be here to present a little glimpse of the gameplay where Agent 47 is on top of the world in Dubai. Enjoy.
Ooh, I'm excited to see this.
But this isn't going to be exclusive.
I mean, yeah.
I would be surprised.
At
yeah,
the most, a timed surprised. Exclusive.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Timed, maybe.
DLC first on PlayStation 5 or something.
Weird, you know, and maybe just because of like all the comedy or like unintentional comedy of Hitman 2.
Yeah.
You know, like seeing this again, it's like it's an about face.
Okay.
So he's getting serious now.
That's it. The trailer. That collar is popped.
Collar's popped. He's had enough.
It means business.
Huh.
That's a random little.
Yeah.
Or is this just? This
hey,
is the
startup. This is your load screen.
Up a PS5.
Let's boot up that PS5. Let's go.
This is very PS2. Was it PS3?
Extremely.
There he is.
Is this a VR
thing?
What am I?
It's Astrobot.
Yeah. Right.
He's so small. Enough him. I mean, look, I'm a big fan of the sound these little bots make. Little Astro bots, it's real adorable.
Okay.
Little playroom, okay, for sure. The kids. You gotta have something for the kids. You gotta justify that purchase to your significant other. It's for the kids.
Getting a
still waiting for my fighting
now.
Game.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What is this?
Okay, I'm into this. I love this perspective already. This is great.
That's very weird. Yep. I like the music.
This is cute.
Yeah.
Weird. Weird and cute. Huh?
Okay, it's like, we took Journey, Shadow of the Colossus, and Red Dead Redemption 2.
And a knife with Tim Burton.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
It's like Edward Gorey.
Yeah.
Characters. Like, I've seen these
that.
In a
I like Schmeet, book. Whatever Schmeet is.
Yeah. Oh, man, there's nothing more I like. So that's what Impossible should name their meat now. It should just be called Schmeet.
Oh, good call.
Then no one has to remember it. You know, it's just, oh, I'm going to have some Schmeet tonight. Schmeetless Mondays.
Oh, okay.
Wait a minute. Hey, this is inappropriate. This is weirdly...
Just like...
Gothic, dark, weird, strange. I like it a
it's
lot.
It's also kind of like super, every game.
It reminds like... me a little bit of games in some way. It's a totally different thing, but I don't know. There's something about it that gives me that vibe. I like this very much. Little Devil Inside.
It looks really inspired by like a lot of different game mechanics.
Yeah,
it
looks cool. Look, like you said, give me just new stuff I've never seen before, right?
Yeah, exactly.
What's up, everyone?
Cute things doing murder stuff. That's one of my favorite.
Cute murder.
Here we go.
Yeah,
the
cute murder is one of my favorite genres.
NBA 2K21. Y'all are not ready for this.
Yay, 2K.
Let's see what the sweat looks like.
That's some early alpha footage.
What becomes before the letter alpha?
I ain't trying to break you down for real. You might as well give up now.
Nice
think you got a chance, but I don't see how. Got a real tight grip when I hold that crown. I'm the first one in and the last one out. Whoever owns the place gotta drag me out.
I feel like we're gonna see more sweat. Oh, I was right.
Oh, look at that.
That is some sweat.
That is the future of sweat.
Quality.
Okay.
Anyone who can jump that high has my respect. I can jump like maybe 4 to 6 inches. Very sad.
For your life.
Fall 2020.
Not gonna lie, guys. The fact that we're just not getting all that needless applause in between all this junk, I'm feeling it.
But we're getting this needless junk.
Hey, I'll take this over like planted audience.
Planted, yes, and employees and stuff. Yeah, you're making an excellent point. It's a game about a strawberry.
Oh man, my son's going.
Oh my god, it comes to life. I was joking. I didn't. I was kidding. I didn't think you were actually going to be the strawberry.
Well, this is their Pikmin answer.
What is this?
Amazing, aren't they? Half bug, half snack.
Whoa.
A very recently discovered species, entirely unique to this island. Oh, this
Don't
one's lively. Beautiful seed patterns.
Oh dear.
Oh, and it's tasty too. Welcome.
He had
to
eyes.
The island of bug snacks.
Nope. I'm terrified.
Oh, wow.
Oh, it's from the. It's Young Horses. Come on, Makers of Octodad. Let's go. This
yep,
is
it looks,
weird AF.
Looks like it's from the Makers of Octodad.
But Octodad was also, same. Very weird. Even a lot of. You know, I have to say, kudos for all the weird stuff that they're putting out. Not your traditional, 45 minutes of shooty mans and then like a little montage of the weird stuff. So I can appreciate, I really appreciate that. as a refreshing weird loving person, weird loving totally. Weirdo. I really appreciate that they're kind of leaning into it.
My invitation is open.
Thank
come
you.
Come join me.
He's
on
a curly
the
fry
island
strawberry.
That's exactly what it is.
I was trying to carry a lamp changing as you are you
yeah,
actually
it looks like
what
whatever
you eat?
You eat yeah.
Oh, you are in fact what you eat.
That cinnamon roll head is making me hungry. I haven't eaten yet.
Look, snacks. Let's do it.
I have a bowl of gummy bears at my desk. Literally, this scene. Is these are my bug snacks. They're bear snacks.
Nice.
We're being cool. attacked.
All right.
Shapes. I knew it.
There it is.
Psychic.
How do you know shapes are going to be next?
I have a fifth sense.
Gotcha. PlayStation 5.
It's a dual sense, one might say. I got a dual sense about it. I'll leave. It's fine.
Yeah, we'll close the door after you.
I'll see myself out. It's fine.
We gotta have a transition,
is it,
guys.
Is it gonna blow everyone's minds when, like, at the end of this, they're gonna be like, every human being you saw in this was rendered out by PlayStation 5. Like, that's the thing I want to see, right? Right at the end, there's a little title card, like, every human being you saw giving a presentation was rendered by PS5.
Oh, count it out. I missed what he said.
Sorry.
I think the title said Head of Independent Studios. Is that what it said?
Okay, this is all right. This is back to heavy hitters.
Could this be Horizon?
Has to be Horizon, right? I mean,
it's
whatever
very
this
pretty.
Is, it's extremely wow. Look at the varied.
Look at the mist.
Oh, the mist
the
is
sky.
The mist is killing me.
The music, the
sounds. I always love the good wind effect.
Yeah, yeah.
On clothing, that's good.
Oh, we got some hell demons. Some hell demon manta rays.
No, like this is not.
Oh, it's medieval.
This is the upgraded. This is the new medieval. They're rebooting the series into something far more.
Is this a From thing?
Is this the Demon Souls?
I mean,
this might be Demon Souls. That looks
very
like
pretty.
He's upset.
He's just waking up.
Yep. There you go.
Wow.
There you go.
Demons of Souls.
I always loved that name.
Dig it. Very pretty.
That looked great.
That looked really good.
So what is that made by From, huh? It was in
Destin is a next-gen first-person shooter.
Arcane, you say?
About rival assassins locked in the time loop.
This is our unique vision, what Arcane is all about. Freeform immersive gameplay, a surreal player-driven story smashed together. Want to see some stylish action? Check this out.
Yeah, yeah, I do.
Sure. Not giving me
yes,
a choice,
please.
But fine.
What if I say no?
Oh, they teased this.
Yeah, I remember this. Has been pronounced guilty of treason. A brief tease. Your assistance is appreciated and mandatory. Yeah, I remember these masks.
Definitely, right?
Yeah. She is not making this easy.
Is this the first, like, shooty man that we've seen?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
In almost an hour?
That's pretty good.
I'm impressed.
Yeah.
It's called!
This is such an arcane thing.
So arcane, yeah.
What is arcane done before?
The sound.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this was very cool.
Good morning, Black Reef. Another day, another death. Aren't time loops fun?
This kind of has a Google 13 kind of vibe.
Everyone
to me.
Else on this island. Mm.
You guys remember that game?
This place
I do. Wow.
A never-ending
Let's
party.
Dig into deep cuts. We got where the deep cuts here because we're all old.
Attraction.
Exactly.
And no matter how I try to escape, they always cut me down.
Yeah, this will be.
But I'm one stubborn motherfucker.
Yeah, I love the concept of this. I think it's very cool.
Super stylish for sure.
Very stylish. Reminds me a little bit of the concept of like a Dead Cells.
Yeah.
Die and go back. Yep. And start over.
Every loop I'm
kind of impressed with the physics of those guys getting shot. It looks
there's eight targets.
Like the way the guy like,
they all
got to
die before
got shot
midnight. There's
hey,
just one
guy can play.
Snack.
You got a dog mask. You can play as a dog now. Let's go, Jeff.
You thought it was going
like
to be good
dog adjacent game.
Juliana Blake, Black Reef's protector, and a real pain in my ass. She may kill me a million times, but eventually, inevitably, I will break this fucking loop.
Earmuffs, everybody, earmuffs.
Okay.
So here's a question. Are you able to go online and play as one of the assassins? And then you play against somebody else? Because that would be amazing.
That would be neat.
Yeah. It's like Spy versus Spy.
Yeah. Where it's like, this is like a real updated kind of version of Spy versus Spy, where it's like, you can log in, go online, choose your assassin, and then you're matched against the other assassin, and then you play against each other. That would be so awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. All right.
I don't
I mean,
like
it looks
watching
fun.
You die.
I like
killing
the
you.
Ground, the grindhouse kind of.
For sure.
Yeah, grindhouse aesthetic, yeah.
Shapes? Oh, we got shapes.
How'd you know?
Okay, we got shapes.
No.
More shapes.
They're now coming out of paper.
They're changing.
So far, all of those rumors, I mean, I'm sure we'll get one of them, but.
I know, yeah. We haven't seen a single one.
Well, we saw Spider-Man and Ratchet
yeah.
and Demon's Souls.
Spider-Man yeah, Ratchet, Ratchet counts. Ratchet counts.
It's two Insomniac games. It's just one studio. But I think people could have guessed a new Ratchet and Clank. Like, that feels like
sure.
a guess. What's
I'm
the
very
spookiness?
Curious to see if Spider-Man is like a full-length thing. But yeah,
yeah right?
Mm, very curious about that. I
mean, especially since it's coming out this year. That's
yeah.
crazy.
All right, what's going on here? Who's his? Whose story is coming to a close here?
The rascal broke free of Mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on.
Box of potatoes.
Over vine, under branch. And into the forest deep.
What is it with that creepy story?
It's just a local tale.
You're really into that stuff?
Quit being so paranoid.
No, no! Friendly! Friendly! Who are you?
Too late.
Who sent you? What's going on?
I want to play as that old man.
Who is?
That's what I want to be. Be a really old caretaker. What's happening? Okay, what are we guessing this is? Is it a silent
game? Oh, yeah. Well, I'm going to say no to Silent Hill.
What is it? Whose story are we closing out?
Prison. No, I don't know.
No. Oh, wait.
His story?
Yeah.
Who's his?
Silent
who's
Hill usually
his?
Has a female protagonist, right? It's creepy. It's good, creepy.
Beautiful creepiness. Yeah. I'm gonna close out his story. So
is this Silent Hill?
What is it? Oh, Resident Evil 8. Look at that VII.
There we go.
That was. Man, you called that with that VII. That was good.
Chris?
It's so pretty.
Sorry, Ethan.
This looks real good.
I gotta see this in 4K.
Oh yeah. My gosh.
Why?
That was intense. He seems upset.
Yeah, Chris Redfield has grown up.
Yeah, he's
all grown up.
Well, we knew that was a game, right? We knew that was definitely happening.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. I wasn't expecting it. That, but yeah, like I want to know more.
It was all first person, right?
Like yeah, I would think they're going again with the first person for sure. Yeah. It was so
but are
good.
You the master of unlocking? That's a real question.
Very good question. Okay.
Hey, look, a different type of space helmet. I like this.
Yeah.
They didn't go with the clear one.
Dead Space? Yeah, that's a very Dead Space you kind of helmet, but this can't be Dead Space, right?
It's like tracking.
Okay.
Is this? Parasite Eve. I'm just kidding.
Nice.
Oh my god. Cats. What's with all the cats, guys?
Yeah, what's going on?
Man, cat
a lot of freaking
are...
cats.
Why is that cat translucent?
Our legion.
That cat's freaking me out.
Don't like the way he's
can we not
I don't like that. I don't please don't ever cut back to that. Don't ever do it. Whoa, reality isn't real.
Okay.
This is very impressive, whatever it is.
From the creepiest trailer,
this
is, so definitely
this just feels weirdest. Like a Kojima thing.
Yeah. Good call. Yeah.
Like, what is going? Like, I mean, come
I don't.
On.
No, actually, I mean, I could see it being like a Remedy game.
You got it. There's got to be some kind of time loop thing.
This is a Christopher Nolan game. Pragmata. Oh, it even sounds like a Christopher Nolan game.
Yeah,
it does.
What is that? Oh, just bring her to the moon. That's what you're gonna do.
Well, she's a robot.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, freedom. She's some kind of robot.
Our freedom.
Okay.
Oh.
Wow, that's a ways off.
What'd they say? What studio?
Well, Capcom's publishing it.
Yeah.
I'm into okay, it.
We're over the hour mark.
We're they over the hour mark. They said
about an hour.
Yeah. Give me 11.
There's like 5 more games that I want to see. So let's come on, PlayStation. Let's go.
Still waiting on my fighter.
Wait, my Horizon Zero Dawn 2. Dang it.
Okay. You might get that here.
Gimme. This is Uncharted 50,000. We knew it. You heard it here first. Maybe, I mean, it could be an Uncharted game.
Perished.
Looks like
1,000 years ago.
Is that Aloy?
They're great cities.
Yeah.
That sounds like Ashley Birch to me.
In their place came new life.
Nice.
Yep. Seems like they're.
I mean, that's almost certainly Ashley Birch. So if this isn't Aloy, I don't know who it is.
Okay.
I don't know what's going with the crab.
Yeah.
Dangerous.
Yeah. There it is. Hooray! I'm so excited. She got her Bluetooth headset.
I must find a way to stop it. Or we'll get worse.
Oh,
even at
1080,
this looks awesome.
This looks stunning.
Look at that water.
Until it destroys us all. There's nothing I wouldn't
do. There's an underwater level, no!
No depth, I won't explore.
Well, they have ray tracing now, so they can finally do underwater.
Ray tracing can solve pretty much anything.
Or never been told.
No secret I won't unlock. No barrier I won't cross.
She has
Thank
actual.
You.
This mission is mine alone.
Okay.
If I falter, if I fail, there won't be anyone left to stop what's coming.
Yep. I remember that guy.
Man, this looks too good. This looks amazing.
I just, the DLC, the Frozen Wilds, is also just so good that this is like, I mean, Forbidden West. It's my nickname for LA.
But whatever comes. I will be ready.
Ugh, all in. All in. Here's all my chips. Just... Here you go. Ugh. I need
On
that.
On behalf of the entire team at Guerrilla, we're happy to share the first look at Horizon Forbidden West.
We're continuing Elga's story as she moves west to her far future America.
To brave a beautiful but dangerous frontier, masked with mysterious new threats.
Get ready to explore distant lands ravaged by massive storms.
And take on new, powerful machines as you return
to the majestic world of Horizon.
Stay tuned for much more. We can't wait for you to get your hands on it.
Hard same.
That's definitely not launch, though. That's like launch window.
Yeah, I wouldn't even think window, dude.
I think there's a lot to look forward to for the community.
Maybe even 2022. Really depends on how long
As
they've been
a
working on
it. As a game designer and storyteller, this is incredibly exciting. We're talking a whole new generation of ideas and experiences that we can create for the player.
No matter where they are, no matter who they are.
New experiences like we've never had before.
More iconic, interesting characters. More atmospheric, immersive worlds for players to explore.
We want to wow players.
Expect the unexpected.
And I, for one, can't wait.
You can't wait.
We can't wait to share them with you.
It's so exciting.
Incredibly exciting.
It's really about love.
As a developer, that's an amazing feeling.
Welcome to PlayStation 5.
Okay.
Welcome. It's a ball pit. Free ball pit for anybody who buys a PS5. Oh my god. There, it's melting. It's converging. Thanks. Are we gonna see it?
No, they're not gonna do it.
Are we gonna see it?
It's coming out of the little balls.
Is it emerging from the ball pit?
No, it's just shapes.
There it is.
That's
not it. If they don't, this would be a real troll. If you get real mad about it, like, come on.
It's just like,
show me the thing. Oh.
Wait a minute. There
Hold
was
on.
Something solid
I saw some
behind
solid,
that.
Yeah, there were not ball pit stuff behind there.
I think you're right there. I think they're just going to tease it.
Just show the
Get out of here.
There you go.
Okay.
Come on. Come on.
It's going to come back.
Oh, it's got vents.
Here
Guess
we go.
What? Guess what? This thing has to spit out hot air.
Oh my God. That's it.
Oh, wow. What the?
Oh, look how pretty it is. I was right. It was white.
You're right.
And that's
that
a
looks
controller.
Good.
That is effing gorgeous.
I mean, it looks like a Las Vegas hotel.
I'll take it.
It looks like
it's
a Sony Vio something.
It's not an ugly box, which I can appreciate. And also, it looks like it's meant to be vertical, which I also appreciate.
I will not use it vertically because I don't have the space, but...
Get out. Get out of here. That is... Real
it looks
nice.
Like a Macross Mecha.
I want it right now. Give me it. Price? Probably not. But
there's no way. Not even release date,
price,
right?
Price? No.
Nope. They would have said it.
Oh, there's more. Oh, wait, there's more.
Get a closer look.
Yeah, let's really just get a... All right.
That
come
looks
on,
like
Jeff.
It's
I know you said it
some...
looks like a Las Vegas hotel, but that is really cool.
Wait,
I guess I like.
It's, wait, a, slim, it's there... a slim version with no optical drive.
Oh, cool.
Oh,
digital edition. That's the one I want.
That's for
that's
sure.
The one you want.
I don't
want the one with
this.
That ugly slot.
Can it go
on
its side though?
It doesn't look like it.
It must. I mean, the
maybe the
Xbox
optical
can
drive
go on
one
its side.
Series accessories.
Cameras.
Was that a camera?
Camera. Yep. Headset. Look at all these accessories that you can buy for a price.
Yes. We won't say what the price is, but...
Okay, well, it does look very futuristic, I will say that.
We hope you've enjoyed the first glimpse of our future today. You've seen our most striking console design yet, and you've seen games that can only be enjoyed with the full range of PlayStation 5's features and power. At PlayStation, we believe in generational transitions, and we put years of work into making them happen. We want you to enjoy the unique benefits of moving from one generation to the next. Thank you for joining us. We're launching later this year, and we have tons more to share. Welcome
Oof.
To PlayStation 5.
Share more now.
What's the startup sound?
It's very Inception-esque. Yeah. It's just La Vie en Rose slowed down.
Miles.
I saw someone online said if I get a Spider-Man co-op game where I can play as Peter and Miles, like I will lose it. I'm like, that sounds so good.
Whatever comes. I will be ready.
She's ready. You don't gotta get ready if you stay ready. And that's Aloy.
I am surprised that that's what this thing looks like. I mean, I know I got finished saying like, oh, it doesn't matter, but.
What surprises you?
I just think it looks, I'm personally
Do you
not
like
a fan.
It?
No,
I was gonna say, yeah, you don't like it.
But it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
No.
It doesn't matter, for sure.
But it does matter to me, who cares about aesthetics. And that'll look real nice in my living room.
See, I don't want it.
Right, like mine's hidden away. Like I never see it.
Mine's out. It's displayed beautifully.
Oh,
like...
they were sideways, maybe. Was that sideways?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think you
might just been an angle.
You might have been right. I don't know. Maybe it was a weird angle.
There's no way they're gonna force you to.
Looks like
display
the terminal of like a new airport.
But I'm so tired of like the same, like these, you know, like a brick. Like that's boring. Bricks are so boring.
Bricks are so 2013 for sure.
They're so 2002. Come on.
I will say this, that thing is not gonna age well.
Who wants design? It to? You're gonna
I'm
buy
just,
another one in
no,
six,
just saying,
seven,
like,
8 years anyway.
I just think it's, you know, it's fine.
It looks like it keeps the SSD and
it's
the
got
GPU
its collar pop
cool.
too.
It also, because it means business, Jeff.
It means business.
It's serious.
There's some major cooling going on in there.
Right?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
A lot of vents. Of air vents.
Oh, yeah.
I think that is the end.
That is it.
Of that. Wow, guys.
We saw the hardware. We weren't sure if we
Woo.
Were going to see it.
Woo.
And we did. Yep. And we did. And we saw lots of it.
They really let you know what that thing looks like. I mean, again, that's to me, that's the smallest bit of news here. So many games. Oh my gosh. I kind of lost count at some point.
We got to have somebody send BVG a picture of the actual console so that we can play it in this big screen right here. So we just show it again.
Yeah. So game wise, you know, I think there's a bit of conflation about like what's exclusive, what's going to be multi-platform. But use your kind of best judgment going on what we kind of know about this industry. What really stood out for you guys? During that an hour and 15 minutes.
Wow. Yeah, it was long.
Yeah.
For me, I would say that Demon's Souls, whatever remake we're going to call it, from a, wow, this looks impressive. Wow, this looks like an order of magnitude better than what I've seen on previous generation. That was the one. Like that mist, those environments, that looked awesome. That has, and I've never played a Dark Souls or Demon's Souls game, so, but that's now top of my list right now.
Now you're ready.
Yeah, I mean,
am red E.
I think either we knew about that was coming or it was rumored. I think for me, you know, look, if you guys can remember when we started this thing off, they started with the GTA 5.
yeah, that was weird. So weird. Like, why would you start?
It felt
with
like
that?
An obligation, kind
yeah.
of. Right?
Yeah, like they made some deal where they're like, okay, listen.
Yeah.
That felt very like contractually obligated.
Yeah. Like maybe they have it in their concert writer that if they were going to present something at a Sony event that they have to go first.
Yeah. Exactly.
So I'm just going to try and go through maybe.
Jeff, what was your number one?
I would probably say there was one of the first original ones that I had not seen so far. I gotta say the Pragmata game. Mm-hmm. I thought that looked interesting.
Yeah.
Little Devil Inside. I'm still sort of thinking about.
Yeah. Cute Murder. Cute murder game. There it is. So yeah. Pretty.
There you have.
It looks so nice. I mean,
right.
It can cover us up. I honestly don't really care.
I wonder if we're going to get like different color varieties and whatnot.
There'll definitely be a black variant of that. Like
you think so?
Yeah. Because the thing is think about all the different iterations of PS4 that we have at this point. It may not be at launch, but there will be a black version and there
That'll
will
be
black DualSense controllers. There will be, They'll at the very least do black variant of all. I've been playing a lot of Animal Crossing, so it's like they'll have the color variants you can order in the store. Everybody loves those. Like if you could maybe customize the controllers in the same way you can with an Xbox controller, like that would be pretty cool.
I love that, not only were they like, hey, here's what it looks like, and here's all the junk you're going to buy.
The other stuff you're going to want. Yeah.
I will say this.
A controller charger. Yes, please.
I fully endorse their headphones. I've used a bunch of their stuff. They're good. They're solid stuff.
Yeah.
There's a camera. Okay. What's that for?
Yeah, I mean, that was the whole thing like 7 years ago. People were like, no cameras, no. But
what if that camera is connected to or has something to do with their VR headset?
Sure. Yeah.
AR sensors, maybe, or something like that.
Yeah, that would make sense. I'd be surprised if PSVR isn't at the least backwards compatible with PS5.
Yeah.
I wonder, you know, so it's interesting. Like, it definitely kind of looks like a boutique like gaming PC in a way, in a lot of ways, and I wonder if like you'll be able to like customize that, you know, ring light around the spine of it there.
That would be very cool.
What is that thing on the far right?
That's the camera on the far right.
Okay,
it's a little camera.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, I just want to appreciate that they have finally moved the charging port from the top of the controller to the bottom.
You notice that?
Yeah, it's interesting. Although you could on the DualShock 4, you can charge it through the bottom. There are third party contraptions.
I just really appreciate that. Like, this is now the official, like, you charge it on the charging dock. It appears that the charging port is now just that USB-C on the bottom, which like, thank you.
I'm hearing from our friends who are helping us produce today, 26 game trailers.
26, that's a lot.
That's
and all like, like I said, like there was a lot of variety.
Yeah.
It didn't feel, because remember there were like, I want to say there were 2 years in a row at E3 where it literally felt like 90% of the games were FPS games. Like it was just first person narrative shooter. And again, I cannot stress enough how much I appreciated that there was so much variety. That Project Athia looks really good. Yeah, I'm very interested in
and
that.
And exclusive too, right? And that's super important because when you do kind of break it down, I am just going through the list I have here.
Look at this beautiful, here's your hotel, Jeff. I'm going to live in this hotel. That's yeah, that's the hotel I want to stay in.
I don't know. It looks very Sony Vaio.
Micro SD card like reader, SD card reader right there on the digital edition? Or that's a USB-C port, I guess.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a thing.
They're just hinting at it. They're teasing it.
Maybe expandable memory, like that might be.
Well, yeah, that's always been like the best thing about these consoles are the easy access to the hard drive.
Yeah,
I don't know what that means in a world where their SSDs are, you know, proprietary in a way that at least the controllers are proprietary in a way that the SSD has to work with the motherboard in a certain way. But if
maybe Sony will release an expandable little SD card that's super fast and works with PS5 or something.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I don't know anyone who hasn't swapped out their hard drive on PS4 for something.
Remember memory cards? That was fun. Never do that again.
Yeah, it's wild. It is definitely.
I like that they're doing the optical list. The digital edition is like a must do now.
But
you,
here's
you just
the thing.
Have to have
that's going to be the cheaper version too, right?
Yeah,
that's what I was getting at. Tell me that's cheaper. I mean, look, an optical drive ain't exactly an expensive piece of hardware, but like, make it, you know,
$50
a better. Yeah, make it $50.
$449 versus $499 or something like that.
Yeah, exactly. I kind of feel like $449 for the optical. And $500 for the one with the disc drive. That's my prediction right now.
Or it's my god, could you imagine if they were like $399?
I'm just trying to
version $399.
Oh god, that would be fantastic.
People would lose their minds.
I'm trying to read the reaction on Twitter about how people feel about the design. And I'm not, I mean, maybe I'm in my own like vacuum of the people I follow, but there's a lot of people saying it looks like something Alienware would have made in the mid 2000s, which
I can see where they're coming from. I don't know.
It doesn't matter.
For sure. And I think it's also going to like, once you have it in your house, it's going to have a different feel. You're going to have a different impression of it once it's actually in your space. You can see a 1080p video of it.
And
I'd
really
like to agree with Tamur, who just tweeted, I've done a lot of research, and it seems that some people like the way the PS5 looks while others don't. Really interesting.
So, Ashley, I don't think we got your impressions of, well, which game impressed you the most or which got you the most excited?
I mean, Horizon Zero Dawn 2 is like that. Horizon Zero Dawn is a game very close to my heart. I played it at what I like to call the right time in my life to have hit me exactly in the place it was aiming for.
Gotcha.
And so I like sobbed at the end of the first game. Like it's so good and meaningful. And it was right before the Switch came out. So it was like that and Breath of the Wild right at the same time.
Yeah.
And so being in these like really big, beautiful kind of open world situations was so fun. For both of them, but this game really captured my imagination. And so to see a second one look familiar, but also so different than the original, like I'm very much looking forward to this. And I'm so excited to see what Guerrilla Games has done harnessing the power of PlayStation 5.
Yeah, and it was kind of answered that question of like, what are these really AAA high-end games going to look like? Like just aesthetically, what kind of style they're gonna go for,
and this is the beginning of the console cycle, which is so exciting.
I know this,
and that's always been the
good.
Most fun thing to think about is what are games gonna look like this and look like on this machine in 5 years. Mind blowing.
I can't even imagine.
And that Resident Evil trailer was also extremely compelling. Extremely compelling.
Yeah, I love the creepiness factor.
Yeah, I mean. I just love like when something kind of hits and, you know, like the fact that it didn't necessarily feel like a sequel to 7 right away. Right. Like there's something about it. I was really into it. And also that Ember Lab game, the Kenya game.
Yeah. That looked really good.
Yeah. That looked super interesting as well. Well, we definitely have a lot to, think about and talk about.
Absolutely.
Thank you guys so much for joining us. This was fantastic.
Yeah, this was fun.
Thanks to Ashley and Eric and our behind the scenes crew helping us put this show together. Brian and Bonnie, everyone being part of it. Thank you so much. Continuing coverage is going to happen for the very foreseeable future on CNN.com as well as our YouTube channel. Thank you for tuning in live. Is there anything else you want to take away, guys? Is there anything else you want to say before we get out of here?
A little disappointed we didn't hear about any smart delivery stuff with the exception of the $1 million in GTA bucks a month.
Thing. Right, yeah. That's your smart delivery right there.
Yeah, a little bummed out that I didn't hear more. That's all.
I don't think you're going to hear more.
I know, but we got the console. We got to see the console. That's true. I'll take it.
You know, I'll give them the benefit of the doubt and say that they promised a game event and they gave a game.
Totally
event.
Fair. So absolutely. Totally fair.
So yeah, look, we got plenty of time until these things come out. So
where's my PlayStation Home upgrade?
I swear in my feed, I saw something wild where someone was trying to say that thing was happening, but probably for the best.
Maybe PSVR 2, something like that.
Thanks everyone for tuning in. A lot of cool stuff coming down the pipe. Last of Us 2 review hitting tonight. Thanks so much for tuning in, everyone. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Bye.